Hello everyone, welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with a new Shopify tutorial, and in this tutorial I'm gonna teach you guys how you can add a countdown timer to your cart and product page, which will help you get more sales. So the countdown timer will look something like this. So you can have your own title, whatever you want to put in, and add in the number of days and hours which will trigger the user to complete your purchase in the store. And you can do the similar with the product page. So you will have it showing up like this in your product page. Again, you can change the colorings, you can change the title and the timer as per your requirement, but that's how it's gonna look like. I'm creating this tutorial in Dawn theme 7.0.1, and it's without using any paid app. You will be doing everything via code. Also, at the end of the video, I'm going to teach you guys how you can add this on a specific product if you want. So if you don't want to display it on all of the products, you can simply add it on one single product if you want, or any specific products in your store. So if you want to learn, please stick to the video and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Huh? Okay, let's jump into the code. Okay guys, so in order to have a countdown timer on your cart page and product page, we'll first go to Shopify backend by navigating to /admin. And from there, we will edit our code. So that's the backend of Shopify. Click on online store. And from there, you will see the activated theme. So currently I have Dawn theme 7.0.1, and we'll be editing this code. So as you can see, I have just added this theme recently, and it's the latest fresh version of the Dawn theme which is available. Okay, now we will edit the code. Click on these three small dots and then edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to save it as a duplicate, so in case you mess up anything, you can easily revert it back. Okay, so that's our code editor, and from code editor we will go to our snippets folder, and in snippet folder we will create a new snippet called countdown. Okay, so that's our new snippet. After adding the file name, click on done. Awesome, our new snippet has been created, and now I'm going to copy the code which I already have prepared. Don't worry about the code, you will find all of the codes with instruction, including in the YouTube video description, where you will find a blog post link, and there you will have all of the instructions ready. Okay, after adding this code, I'm gonna save the file. And now if I go to this and hit refresh, you will see that there is no countdown timer showing up because I have activated the latest version of Dawn theme where there is no editing being done. Okay, now in order to add the countdown timer on your cart page, I'm gonna go to main-cart-item.liquid, main-cart-items.liquid. Click on that file. In that file, you will need to search for form. So it's line number 45. In case you are using any other theme, or in case you're using any different version of Dawn theme, you can find this line of code, which is the starting of this section here, and add and include the snippet which we just created. So this code should work on all of the themes, not only Dawn theme, but this instruction is being created for in Dawn theme 7.0.1. So if you guys have added, if you guys will add it on the wrong line, it might not work properly, but in Dawn theme it should work in line number 45. Okay, so I'm going to copy the code for the snippet which we created. Again, you will find all of the codes in YouTube video description, so you don't need to worry about that. So I have included this countdown snippet which we created in our cart file, and that's the title, again, which you can change as per your requirements, and these are the timings which I have set. You can also change this as per your requirement. Now hit save, and once I save this file, I should be able to see the countdown timer if I refresh. Cool. So our countdown timer is showing up. As I said, you can change the heading and you can change the timing. Let me show you how. So you just need to change the title here. So for example, I just remove this text from here and hit save. Now when I go back and hit refresh, it should update the title. As you can see, the title has been updated. Similarly, I'll show you how to change the timing. So in this case, I'll just increase the ending date, which will be 13 November. So currently the time which I'm creating video is 12th November. I have added 13th November as an end date. Now it should add an additional day here. If I hit refresh, as you can see, it's showing that there is still 1 day and 3 hours left for Black Friday sale to end. Again, you can change the title and the timing as per your requirement. Also, if you need to change the background color and text color, all of the code is within this file, the snippet which we created. So scroll down where you will see the CSS. And so that's for the title. This code is for the title. So if you change the color from white to any other color which you need, so for example, if I change it to red color and hit save, my title color will be changed. Hit refresh and here you go. The title color is changed to red. Similarly, you can change the timer color here, and which is available here. So dot timer is for this clock, the timer. So if I change the color from white to red, it will update the color. Hit refresh. And I think we did some mistake. Sorry, we shouldn't be including that hash. Now click save. And hit refresh. There we go. Our timer color has been updated. Now let's try to change the background color. For the background color, you can simply add in your color code here or define what color you need. So if you don't like the black and if you want it in plain white, we can just add here the white color. Hit save and you will see that it's changed from black to white. There we go. Our color has been changed. So that's it for the coloring styling. Now we will add this timer in our product page, right? And in order to do that, I'm going to go to main-product.liquid file. So that's our file where we will be adding our code. And in there, we will again copy this code and go to line number 31. So here's the line where we will be adding our code. You can search for this line in your file. If the line number doesn't match, you can simply search this line and add your snippet code below that. So I've included that now. Okay, it's safe. And now just go to the product page and hit refresh. Here we go. Our timer is showing up now. Again, you can add the timing as per your requirement and change the title. Now, what if you want to include this timer only in one product? So currently, if I go to any other product in my store, it will show up on all of them. So that's the product I'm already in. Now let's open up this one. Timer is showing up here. And if I open up this one, so all of the products are showing up the timer right now. What if you want to include the timer only in one product? We can do this really easily. All you have to do is include an if condition. So just add in if product dot handle equals to, for example, this specific product. Now what is product handle? Product handle is what shows after slash products, the ending of the the name of the product in URL. You can also find the product handle within from the back end of your store. So if I go to the backend and search and go to this product, I will have the handle showing up on the bottom of the product editing section. So let's go to products and then click on blue t-shirt. And from there, if I scroll down to the bottom and click edit here, so that's your product handle. As it says itself, URL handle, that's your product handle. So I'm just gonna copy this product handle and add it in my code, which says if product handle equals to blue t-shirt, display this, otherwise just end this code and if. So you just need to add this if condition if you want to include the timer or if you want to have multiple timers included on your store. Okay, now I'm going to click on save and see if the code's working fine. Now after the file is being saved, I'm going to go on any other product. So first let's do this one. As you can see, my timer on this product is not showing up. Similarly for this product, we don't have any timer, but when I go to the blue t-shirt where we defined it that we need to have it on blue t-shirt, it will show up completely fine, right? Okay guys, that's it for the tutorial. If you liked it, don't forget to comment on the video below. Again, all of the codes will be available in the blog post description, or if you have any other confusion or if you want to implement the similar tutorial for any other theme, don't forget to comment on the video below and I'll help you as soon as possible. Until the next video, have a great day.